Oh, there are two main types of the bone marrow, the red and the yellow marrow. So, bone marrow is generally termed for soft tissue occupying the medullary cavity of the long bone. So, tandaan nyo, sa red marrow, nagproproduce ng red blood cell. And, ang yellow naman consists of adipose. So, red bone marrow looks like blood but with thicker consistency. Consists of delicate mesh of reticular tissue saturated with immature red blood cells and scattered adipocytes. So, in a child daw, sa medullary cavity, maraming red bone marrow. So, in young to middle-aged adults, the shaft are long bones are filled with yellow bone marrow. So, yellow marrow no longer produces blood, although in the event of severe chronic anemia, it can transform back into red marrow. So in adults, red marrow is limited to the axial skeleton, pectoral girdle, pelvic girdle, and proximal heads of the humerus and the femur. This is the microscopic structure of the compact bone. It consists of multiple cylindrical structure as osteon or Haubertian system. So imagine these osteons with very pillars that are arranged parallel to one another along the long axis of the compact bone. So the diagram below represents a long bone shaft in cross-section. Each yellow circle represents the osteon and blue represents the additional matrix. So osteon, isang osteon is also known as the Haubertian system. So surrounded by concentric layers of calcified bone matrix. So Haubertian canals allows the passage of blood vessel, lymphatic, and nerve fibers. Each of the concentric matrix tubes that surrounds a Haubertian canal is known as lamella. All the collagen fibers, in particular lamella, run in a single direction. So, tapos sa kabilang, sa other side naman, adjacent naman, and kabila naman opposite. This will allow bone to better withstand twisting forces. Diba ang galing? So, ito yan, isang Boxman canal. Running perpendicular to the Haubertian canals, they connect the blood vessels of nerve supply to the periosteum to those in the Haubertian canal and in the medullary cavity. So, osteons, ayan, isang osteon, Haubertian system, ito. So, these are, meron tayong type ng mga lamellae. So, lying between intact osteons are incomplete lamellae. So, may interstitials fill the gaps between the osteons or the remnants of the bone remodeling. So, yan ito, interstitial lamellae. Ito isang osteon din to. So, there are also circumferential lamellae. The textures around the circumference of the shaft. There are inner circumferential lamellae surrounding the endosteum and outer circumferential lamellae just inside the periosteum. So, spider-shaped osteocytes occupy small cavities known as the lacunae. At the junctions of the lamellae, hair-like canals called canaliculi connect the lacunae to each other and to the central canal. Canaliculi allow the osteocytes to exchange nutrients, waste, and chemical signals to each other via intercellular connection known as the gap junctions ulit. So, yan ito, osteocytes. Lacunae. Canaliculi. Yan. Isang osteon. So here we have a close and far away view of the compact bone. You should be able to identify Haubertian canals, concentric lamellae, interstitial lamellae. So yan. Microscopic structure of the spongy bone. So lux osteo naman ang spongy bone. So, bone development is also known as osteogenesis and ossification. So, process of bone tissue formation, the embryo, this lead to the formation of the bone skeleton. The children na young adults, ossification occurs as a part of bone growth. And in adults, it occurs as a part of bone remodeling and bone repair. So, formation of body skeleton. Before week 8, the human embryonic skeleton is made of fibrous membranous hyaline cartilage. After week 8, bone tissue begins to replace the fibrous membranous hyaline cartilage. The development of bone from a fibrous membrane is called intramembranous ossification. And replacement of hyaline cartilage with bone is known as endochondral ossification. So, intramembranous ossification. So, some bones of the skull, frontal, parietal, temporal, occipital bones of the facial bones, the pelvis and the scapulae, part of the mandible, are formed by the intramembranous ossification. Prior to ossification, these structures exist as fibrous membranes made of embryonic connective tissue known as mesenchyme. Mesenchymal cells cluster together. So, components of the bone matrix. Yeah. So, the location in the tissue where ossification begins is on ossification centers. Yeah, ossification centers. Developing bone grows outward from the ossification center in a small strut called spicules. So, mesenchymal cell division provide additional osteoblasts. The osteoblasts require reliable source of oxygen, nutrients, and blood vessel. So, blood vessels trap among the spicules meet these nutrients. So, initially, the intramembranous bone consists only of spongy bone. Subsequent remodeling around trap the blood vessels can produce osteons typical of compact bone. As the rate of the growth slows, the connective tissue around the bone becomes organized into fibrous layers or periosteum. Osteoblasts close to the bone surfaces become the inner circular layer of the periosteum. So, endochondral ossification begins with the formation of the hyaline cartilage model, which will later be replaced by the bone. So, yun sa mga baby natin. So, most bones in the body develop via this model. More complicated than intramembranous because the hyaline cartilage must be broken down into ossification process. We'll follow the limb bone development as an example. So, yan. Step 1. Chondrocytes near the center of the shaft of the hyaline cartilage model increases greatly. As these cells enlarge, their lacunae expand the matrix and are reduced in a series of thin struts. So, enlarged chondrocytes are now deprived of nutrients, cannot occur through calcified calcium. Soon, they die and disintegrate. So, yeah. And the chondrocalcification. Blood vessels grow into the perichondrium surrounding the shaft. The cartilage cells of the inner layer of the perichondrium in the region, then differentiation into osteoblasts. Perichondrium is now periosteum, and the inner osteogenic layer soon produces a thin layer of bone around the shaft of the cartilage. So, this bony collar provides support. So, blood supply to the periosteum, capillaries and fibroblasts migrate into the heart of the cartilage, invading the space left by the disintegrating chondrocytes. So, calcified cartilage matrix breaks down to fibroblasts, differentiate into osteoblasts that replace with spongy bone. So, bone development begins at this primary center of ossification and spreads toward both ends of the cartilaginous model. While the diameter is small, the entire diaphysis is filled with spongy bone. So, the primary ossification center enlarges proximally and distally, while osteoclasts break down the newly formed spongy bone and open up the medullary cavity in the center of the shaft. So as the osteoblasts move towards the epiphysis, the epiphyseal cartilage is growing as well. Thus, even though the shaft is getting longer, the epiphysis is yet to be transformed into a bone. Step 5. Around birth, most long bones have bony diaphysis surrounding the remnants of the spongy bone, so widening the medullary cavity and cartilaginous epiphysis. At this time, capillaries and osteoblasts will migrate into the epiphysis and create secondary efficacy center. So yan yung epiphyseal plate natin. So the epiphysis will transform into spongy bone. However, small cartilaginous plate known as epiphyseal plate will remain at the junction between the epiphysis and the diaphysis. Yan. So growth and bone length. So the epiphyseal cartilage close to the epiphysis of the epiphyseal plate divides into create more cartilage, while the epiphyseal cartilage close to the diaphysis of the epiphyseal plate is transformed into bone. So this increases the length of the shaft. So at puberty, growth and bone length is increased dramatically by combining activities of growth hormone, thyroid hormone, and sex hormone. So yan yung tatlo. As a result, osteoblasts begin producing bone mass much faster than the rate of epiphyseal cartilage expansion. Thus, the bone grows while the epiphyseal plate gets narrower and ultimately disappear. Kaya, nagkakaroon ng epiphyseal line. So, visible on x-ray. Yan o. Growth in bone thickness. So, osteoblasts, the periosteum secrete bone matrix on the external surface of the bone. This obviously makes the bone thicker. At the same time, osteoclast on the endosteum breaks down bone, thus widen the medullary cavity. This results in the increase in shaft diameter, even though the actual amount of bone in the shaft is relatively unchanged. Yeah. So, may mga, ano, pag nabalian tayo ng buto, fractures yung tawag doon. So, damaged constituents are fractures. So, despite the mineral strength, bone may crack or even break if subjected to extreme load, sudden impacts, or stress. So, the proper healing of fracture depends on whether or not the blood supply and cellular components of the periosteum and endosteum survive. Yan, fracture repair. So, step 1, immediately after the fracture, extensive bleeding occurs over the period of several hours. A large blood clot or fracture hematoma develops. Ayan, ito. Hematoma natin. Yan. So bone cells at the site become deprived of nutrients and die, and the site becomes swollen, painful, and inflamed. So number 2, granulation tissue is formed at the hematoma, infiltrated by capillaries and macrophages, which begin to clean up the debris. Some fibroblasts produce collagen fibers that span the break, while others differentiate into chondroblasts and begin secreting the cartilage matrix. So, osteoblasts begin forming spongy bone. This entire structure is known as fibrocartilaginous callus and splints the broken bone. So, callus formation. So, step 3, bone trabeculae increase in the number and convert fibrocartilaginous callus into bony callus. So, the spongy bone typically takes around 6 to 8 weeks for this to occur. So during the next several months, the bony callus is continually remodeled. Osteoclasts work to remove the temporary supportive structure, while osteoblasts rebuild the compact bone. So, meron tayong different types ng fracture. So, tandaan natin yung may open, may close, comminuted, green stick, spiral, and impacted. So, open, kapag penetrate the skin. Kapag close, bone ends don't penetrate the skin. Comminuted yung durog-durog bone fragments into 3 or more pieces. So, usually sa mga elderly, brittle na kasi yung bone nila, may osteoporosis na sila. Green stick, bone breaks incompletely. So, may bali pero hindi siya buong nabali yung buto. Usually, one-sided lang or one-side broken lang. So, common ito sa mga children. Spinal rugged break caused by excessive twisting versus sports injury and injury of abuse. And, syempre, impacted. Yan, impacted yung buto. So, yan, mga different types. So, simple fracture. Close siya kasi hindi naman lumabas sa balat. Yan. To open. Yun, lumabas sa balat. Green stick yung hindi buo yung pagka-fracture. So, example, ito, what kind of fracture is this? Ito. Mukha siyang, Oh, nadurog yung buto niya eh. Anong bone muna siya? Ang bone na yan ay radius. So, meron siyang fracture sa radial bone. Is it open or closed? Mukha siyang nadurog, no? So, mukha siyang comminuted. Open, comminuted. So, ito naman, it's kind of tough to tell, but this is a mukhang ano siya, impacted. Diba? So, yung impacted natin, one bone fragment is driven into another bone. Hindi naman siya green sticky kasi yan talaga. Nag-fracture talaga. So, yan. Bone remodeling. So, meron tayong tinatawag na Wolfsmann law. Holds that bone will grow or remodel in response to the forces demand placed on it. So, example, this will be the bone on the left. Check out the mechanism in the modeling on the right. So, why might you suspect someone who's been powerlifter for 15 years to have heavy, massive bones, especially at the point of muscle insertion? So, ayun, diba kaya ang mga buto ng mga bodybuilders ay mataas din, malakas din, malalaki din yung buto nila. Sa astronauts naman, tend to experience bone atrophy, lumilit yung buto kasi hindi sila naglalakad. So, after the you're in space for extended period, nag-atrophy yung buto natin. So, nagre-remodel siya. Depende sa activity natin. So, nutritional effects on the bone. So, normal bone growth maintenance cannot occur without sufficient dietary intake of calcium and phosphate. So, calcium and phosphate are not absorbed in the intestine unless calcitriol is present. So, calcitriol synthesizes the dependent on the ability of the steroid called cholecalciferol, also known as the vitamin D, which may be synthesized in the skin by or obtaining by the diet. So, vitamin C, A, K, and B12 are all necessary for bone growth as well. Hormonal effects. Growth hormone produces by the pituitary gland and thyroxine. Produce the thyroid gland. Stimulates the bone growth. So, GH, the growth hormone, stimulates protein synthesis and the cell growth throughout the body. So yan yung nagpapatangkad, pagpapatlaki sa atin. So thyroxine stimulated cells and increases the rate of osteoblast activity. So in proper balance, these hormones maintain normal activity of the epiphyseal plate. What you consider normal activity until roughly time at the puberty. So yan, yung dalawa nating endocrine organs, si pituitary gland and thyroid gland. So si pituitary gland, specifically the anterior pituitary gland, is producing the growth hormone. And the thyroid gland producing thyroxine. Or the thyroid hormone also helps in the growth hormone in the increasing the osteoblast activity. So dalawa sila sa nagko-cause ng increased production ng bone matrix. So at puberty, the rising levels of sex hormone estrogen in the females and androgens in cause osteoblasts to produce bone faster than the epiphyseal cartilage can divide. This causes the characteristic growth spurt as well as the ultimate closure of the epiphyseal plate. So estrogen causes faster closure of the epiphyseal growth plate than to androgens. So estrogen also acts stimulate osteoblast activity. So yeah, so estrogen daw nagpapabilis ng closure ng epiphyseal plate. So yan yung kaya tayo tumatangkad. So other hormones, yung insulin and glucocorticoid. So insulin stimulates bone formation. So glucocorticoids inhibit osteoclast activity. So yun, parathyroid hormone and calcitonin are two hormones that antagonistically maintain blood calcium level at homeostatic levels. So since the skeleton is the body's major calcium reservoir, the activity of these two hormones affects directly bone resorption and deposition. So si calcitonin releases the C cells of the thyroid gland in response to high blood. So high blood calcium level. So calcitonin acts as a toned down blood calcium level. So calcitonin causes decreased osteoclast activity, which result in decreased breakdown of bone matrix and decreased calcium being realized into the blood. So yun. So calcitonin also stimulates osteoblast activity, which means calcium will be taken from the blood and deposited as bone matrix. So ito yung negative feedback na ating sa calcium homeostasis or balance. So kapag increase yung blood calcium, ano yung ma-activate natin dyan is the osteoblast. Kasi kailangan niya mag-deposit sa pasok sa loob ng buto. So increased calcitonin release from the thyroid C cells. So yan. So parathyroid hormone yan yung nagpo-produce ng parathyroid hormone yung pinaproduce ng parathyroid. So makikita din siya malapit sa thyroid, sa likuran. Yan, merong apat. Two pairs. So, release the cells of the parathyroid gland in the response to low blood. E, ganun. Dapat nag-project din siya. Diba? So, released by the cells of the parathyroid gland in response to low blood calcium. So, parathyroid hormone will bind to osteoblast. And this will cause two things to occur. So, number one, the osteoblasts will decrease their activity and they will release chemical known as osteoclast stimulating factor. Osteoclast stimulating factor will increase osteoclast activity. So, parathyroid hormone increases calcitriol synthesis, which increases calcium absorption in the small intestine. Parathyroid hormone decreases urinary calcium excretion and increases urinary phosphate excretion. Ayan, yan ang ating diagram. Decreased blood calcium. Increased parathyroid release by the parathyroid gland. Binds it. So, ayan. So, yun nung diagram. So, pag decrease naman ang blood calcium, increase yung yun yung kanina parathyroid hormone release. So, pag increase siya, increase yung calcitriol synthesis, decrease calcium excretion, and binds to osteoblast, causing decreased osteoblast naman. So, yung activity niya is osteoclast naman. So, OSF causes increased osteoclast activity. And syempre decrease bone this deposition and increase bone response. So yan na. So decrease bone deposition and increase bone resorption. So increase blood calcium. So meron tayong mga different kinds of clinical condition. Yung osteomalacia or soft bones includes many disorder in which osteoid is produced but inadequately mineralized. Causes can include the insufficient dietary calcium. Osteomalacia, soft. So, insufficient vitamin D fortification or insufficient exposure to the sunlight. So, rickets, children's form osteomalacia more detrimental due to the fact amurit pa lang mag-check nyo. So, signs include bone legs, deformities. So, yan. Tandaan nyo, guys. So yan, di ba, yan na yan. So yan yung mga deformities natin. Osteomyelitis is the inflammation of the bone. So, inflammation of the bone, bone marrow caused by the pus forming bacteria that enters the body via wound. So, example, pag may fracture tayo, high risk din sila magkaroon ng infection. Pre-expose sila sa labas, lalo na pag open fracture. So, ngayon, binibigyan lang natin yan sila ng antibiotics. Mga matitinding antibiotics natin. So, ito, osteoporosis group of disease in which bone resorption occurs at the faster rate than the bone deposition. So, bone mass drops and bones become increasingly porous. Ayan, sa mga matatanda. Compression, fractures of the vertebra, and fractures of the femur are common. Often seen in postmenopausal women because they experience rapid decline in estrogen secretion. So, estrogen stimulates osteoblasts and inhibits osteoclast activity. So, based on above, what preventive measures might you suggest? Ano masasuggest natin? Siyempre, mag-inom na agad ng milk as early as 40 years old. Siyempre, para mas marami tayong calcium deposits. So, other clinical condition is gigantism. So, hypersecretion ng growth hormones by the pituitary gland. Acromegaly, pag nag-close na yung apical plate natin, pero still pa rin nag-produce ng growth hormones, palapad na siya yung tao. So, pag child hypersecretion, gigantism. Pag adulthood hypersecretion ng growth hormones, acromegaly. So, pituitary dwarfism in children resulting in extremely short long bones, maximum of stature 4 feet. Yung mga una, no? Thank you. That will be all. So, we will study further. Chapter 2 of the skeletal system.